हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. ओके, इन दिस वीडियो लेट्स हैव द रिकैप्चुलेशन, द रिविजन पार्ट ऑफ लेसन नंबर 5, सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. ओके, आई नो द लेसन इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू ऑल. ईच एंड एवरी कंसेप्ट ऑफ द लेसन इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर टू ईच एंड एवरीबडी इफ यू हैव अटेंडेड द वीडियोज विथ फुल ऑफ योर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. But still, I think that one more time, let us have the key points, the main points of the lesson we'll have to revise. Okay. So first of all, let me tell you why do we need to separate the substances. Okay. Obviously, we need to separate the substances for to make the things pure. Okay. Purity is a reason. Okay. While separating grains from the stalks, farmer also need to get the pure grains. For that reason, they are using all these techniques, all these method to separate the substances. Okay, so why do we need to separate the substances? Obviously, for purity, to make the things pure or to get the things pure. Okay, first of all, let us see, as already we have discussed it, but let us see as a revision part, different methods of separations. Okay, in methods of separations, we saw hand picking, then we saw threshing, then we saw winnowing, then sieving. These are the method we have seen in the initial while we have started the lessons. Okay, sieving. Hand picking, threshing, winnowing and sieving. What is hand picking, threshing, winnowing and sieving? These are the methods of separations used by the farmers. Okay, hand picking, as the name itself indicate, the larger size of impurities. The larger size of impurities picked by hand. Okay, it is only possible when the quantity of grain is less. Okay, if we have 50 kg of grains, so not possible for a person to pick all the larger impurities from the, you know, such a larger quantity. But the size of the impurities should be the larger. Okay, then only it can be possible to pick up impurities from the grains. We saw, while for example, when our mother used to make rice, or other mother used to make any special dish for us, she used to first pick up the stones, if any of the stones are present in the particular rice, or you know, whatever she used to prepare. So these things already we have discussed in the previous video. Next, threshing. Threshing is nothing but when farmer used to beat the stalks of the grains on the harder surface. Okay, must say beating stalks of the grains. On harder surface. Okay, these are the key points of the lesson. That's why I am just revising it everything. Okay, in threshing, beating stalks of the grains on the harder surface to make the stalks and the grains separate. This is the method used by the farmers, while we have already discussed. Next, winnowing. Winnowing is nothing but when the person used to stand at the height and pouring the grains with the, you know, grains and stalks are together, pouring the grains which have smaller size of impurities, and with the flow of air the impurities will fly far away from the farmer, and the pure grains will be stored nearby him. So that is the process of winnowing. Okay, we can say pouring grains from height with the flow of air. Okay, pouring grains from height with the flow of air, and with the flow of air the grain will be separated from the stalks or whatever smaller impurities is present in the grains. Okay, next, sieving. Sieving is done with the help of sieve. Okay, you all know construction side of things, or farmer also many a times use the sieve. Okay, sieve is nothing but is made up of a metal, okay, having the small kinds of holes on it, and if you pour grains or whatever things on it, the larger size of impurities will be separated with the help of this sieve. Okay, a metal sieve with the help of metal sieve the things used to separate. Okay, these are the methods we have already discussed in lesson number 5 while discussing separation of substances. Okay, let me tell you, these all are solid things. Okay, grains, whatever we did here, separation we all did with the help of solid things only. Okay, now let us discuss semi solid, means solid plus liquid. Okay, the mixture of solid and liquid, how do we separate the mixture of solid and liquid? Okay, let's see. I hope it is clear to you all. These are the basic separation methods. Okay, now we'll see as I told you just now, grain is nothing but a solid thing. Okay, now we have to talk about solid and liquid mixture. Okay, mixture of solid and liquid. So in that we have to discuss three processes, that is sedimentation, then decantation, then filtration. Okay, let us take the example of salty water. Let us take the example of salty water. Sorry, before that let us take the example of muddy water, or the water which is with the sand, sandy water. Okay, water and sand. As we all know, we have to take this mixture of sand and water, we have to keep it aside for couple of minutes, and you will observe that the impurities will be settled down, or the sand will be settled down as it is heavier than water, and as it is not dissolved, it is not soluble in water, so it will settle down at the bottom and the water will be floating up. The process is called sedimentation. Okay, impurities settle at the bottom. Okay, simply I just want to summarize the whole lesson, so few points are there from my side. Okay, so here impurities settle at the bottom in sedimentation. Decantation, clean water pour into another container. Clean water or decanted water, we can say. Okay, clean water or decanted water can be poured into another beaker. Okay, in decantation impurities decanted water or clean water can be poured into another container. Okay, now we have this decanted water which is clean, we cannot say it is pure. Maybe smaller size of impurities can be present in it. So for that we have to go for filtration process. In filtration we all know we have to arrange one funnel having the filter paper on it on the top of the funnel, and whatever we have this decanted water can be pass or can be pour into the funnel through the filter paper. Okay, so decanted water pour through filter paper is nothing but the filtration. Decanted water pour through filter paper. Decanted water can be poured through filter paper. So these are the three methods of separation while discussing the mixture of solid and liquid things. Okay, first of all, initially at the starting of the lessons we have discussed the solid things, how we have to separate. Now we study these three process, that is sedimentation, decantation and filtration respectively, to separate the mixture of solid and liquid things. Now let us move forward how to separate the soluble impurities, the soluble things which completely dissolve in water. Okay, already over, just revision part is there. Okay, recapitulation part is there. You can make the notes with me. Okay, I am just simply giving you some definitions and some, you know, written part which is very useful for your further studies. Okay, so two things is over here. First of all, we have seen when solid grains, how to separate, separation methods like winnowing, threshing, hand picking and sieving. Okay, in secondly, while we talk about solid and liquid mixture, then we have seen the process of sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Now we can go for the things which are completely soluble in water. Okay, let us have the example of salty water. Okay, salty water, salt plus water. What to do? Yes, here we have to go for the method of evaporation. Okay, evaporation is nothing but, as I gave you the definition of evaporation in previous video, the process in which the process of conversion of water into water vapor, the process of conversion of water into its vapor form is called evaporation. So by the process of evaporation we can easily separate salt and water separately. Okay, we have to boil the water. Ultimately water gets heated and it will changes into water vapor, and what we get? We get pure salt. Same thing we can apply with the sugar and water, which is sweet water. Sugar can be separated from the water by the evaporation method. Okay, let's talk about condensation. Okay, evaporation, the process. Sorry, the same definition we'll continue. Okay, otherwise you will get confused. We can define evaporation in many ways, but simply we'll define in that way. The process of conversion of water, the process of conversion of water into its vapor is called evaporation. Okay, it is totally opposite, the process, yes, of conversion of vapor into its liquid form, okay, is called condensation. okay, we can separate the things with the help of condensation as well. While as you all know, when vapor, first of all water gets boiled, changes into water vapor, and when water vapor touches the lead, it will again change into the water vapor. Once you will feel that salty water is completely dissolved in water, how can we separate salt and water, or how can we separate sand and water? So by the with the help of this condensation process, we can separate the sand, salt and water at the different places. Okay, the process in which vapor changes into water while cooling is called condensation. Okay, so here we are covered with the revision part of lesson number 5. Okay, already is a twice revision. I hope all the things are very clear to you. Okay, so that's all for today. In next video, I'll give you the exercise part of this lesson. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.